Hello guys, in this particular video we will take particular example of MOSFET for DC analysis numerical. Okay, that is basically for 6 to 8 marks. So this particular example is given to have this is 400 ohm which is given, this is 3.2 kilo ohm which is given, and 20 volts which is given, 3.2 kilo ohm which is given. That is nothing but your value of RD, drain resistance, 400 ohm source resistance, and 1 mega ohm which is given as the value for RG. Okay, few more values are given as IDSS is equal to 8 milliamperes and VP which is equal to minus 4 volts. So we have to calculate. They ask us find the value of Q point. Find Q point for given circuit. This is the question. Question is so simple. We just have to find out Q point for the given circuit. That means VGSQ, VDSQ and IDQ. So we'll follow the steps. Step 1 is not required as this is not a voltage divider bias. So we'll directly move to the step number 2. We will say apply KVL to input side. We'll apply KVL to input. We will be getting IG, RG, right, minus VGS minus ID into RS is equal to 0. As IG, RG is equal to 0, it's not required. So we can say that this VGS is equal to minus ID into RS. And that is nothing but ID is hidden, but RS is given. So I can say that minus 0.4 kilo into ID. This is nothing but equation number 1. Okay, 0.4 kilo into ID. Now, using equation of current, that is ID is equal to IDSS multiplied by 1 minus VGS divided by VP the whole square. IDSS which is given, that is 8 milli, right? ID is ID as it is. IDSS 8 milliampere. Okay, we'll put the value of VGS, that is minus of 0.4 kilo into ID. So here we will write minus of 0.4 kilo into ID divided by VP, that is given as minus 4 volts. So minus 4 the whole square. Okay, so minus and this minus will get cancelled and this minus sign will remain as it is. Okay, so far we will be getting, we will simplify this, we'll be getting ID is equal to 8 milli divided by 16. I'm taking minus 4 square outside, and here we will be getting 4 minus 0.4k, right, multiplied by ID the whole square. Simplifying this further, we will be getting 2k at the left hand side. Milli at the left hand side will form k. kilo, and 8 by 16, that is 0.5, at the left hand side will become 2. So here we'll be getting 2k into id is equal to 4 square. We'll solve this a minus b the whole square. So this will become 16 minus 4 into 2 into 0.4 into k. Okay, multiplied by id obviously, plus 0.4k into id the whole square. So if we find out the value of 0.4k square, so this will become 160 kilo, right? So this will become 160 kilo into id square. Okay, so let's simplify this into quadratic equation. So we'll be getting 160k into id square minus 4 into 2, 8. 8 multiplied by 0.4, that is 3.2 minus 3.2 into id plus 16. We'll keep this on the left hand side only, minus 2k into id is equal to 0. Minus 3.2 id minus 2, here k is missing, so minus 3.2k into minus 2k, so that forms your minus 5.2k id. So complete quadratic equation becomes 160k into id square minus 5.2k into id plus 16 is equal to 0. Right, so we'll solve this quadratic equation, then we will be getting the value of id after solving. We'll be getting value of id 1 is equal to 29 milliampere, and another value is 3.44 milliampere. Now look at these two values carefully and compare with the value of IDSS. Given is IDSS, which is equal to 8 milliampere, right? If we draw the characteristics graph, then we'll get to know that this is nothing but your VGS, this is nothing but your ID, right? And as we move further for the negative values of VGS towards the value of VP, right, my value of ID should be less than 8 milliampere, which is IDSS. Okay, so we will take the value, which is, we will take the value 3.44, which is correct, and this is invalid, right? So as IDQ, which is less than IDSS, so this value is correct. Okay, so we will be getting IDQ is equal to 3.44 milliampere. Now what we will do, once we get the value of ID, we will just put this value of ID in your equation number 1. Okay, so what we will do, we will be getting the value of VGS from equation 1 and IDQ. VGSQ will become 0.4 minus 0.4 k into IDQ, that is equal to minus 1.376 volts. Now, whatever value of VGSQ we have got, that is less than the value of VP, which is given as minus 4 volts. Okay, so we will plot the Q point over here, that is nothing but the x-axis corresponds to the value of VGSQ and y-axis corresponds to the value of IDQ. Okay, so this is the value of Q point where we'll be getting the, now we have got the value of Q point, right, where IDQ is equal to 3.44 milliampere and VGSQ is equal to minus 1.376 volts. Okay. Now we'll use these two values, rather with these particular values, we will go through the finding the another parameter of the Q point, that is VDSQ. Okay. So we first of all, we will write first parameter of Q point, that is nothing but let's say Q point where VGSQ comma IDQ, which is equal to VGSQ is minus 1.7376 volts and IDQ is nothing but 3.44 milliampere. Okay, let's move to the step number 3, that is apply output KVL. We will apply output KVL now. Let's say this is the value of RD, which is given as how much? 3.2 kilo ohm. Okay. This is the MOSFET which is given, D type of MOSFET. This is the value which is 400 ohm and is connected to ground. Now we are least concerned about the input side. We will just concern about the output side because we want only the parameter which is left is VDS. Right, so apply KVL right to the output side, we will be getting plus VDD minus ID into RD minus VDS minus ID into RS is equal to 0. Right, now we'll say at ID is equal to IDQ, VDS whatever we will be getting, that is nothing but VDSQ, right? So we will say, we'll put the value of ID is equal to IDQ, right? That is nothing but this 3.44 milliampere, right? So we'll get direct equation of VDSQ is nothing but VDD minus, we'll take ID common and this will become RD plus RS. All the values are known to me very well, okay? VDD is equal to 20 volts. Minus ID is equal to 3.44 milliampere and RD is equal to 3.2k and 400, that is nothing but 0.4k. So 3.2 plus 0.4, that is nothing but 3.6k. Okay, so we'll write here directly 3.6 kilo ohm. Kilo and milli will get cancelled each other. So ultimately, whatever value you will be getting, that will be 20 minus 3.44 multiplied by 3.6. So we'll calculate this value, 7.616. So your value of VDSQ is nothing but 7.616 volts. Okay, so we will get all the Q parameters, that is nothing but VGSQ, right? One is minus 1.376 volts, another is IDQ, that is nothing but 3.44 milliampere, and third point which is nothing but VDSQ, that is 7.616 volts. So this is nothing but the answer of my given question. Okay, so we will solve more and more examples as we will move further for particular types of the questions in the next videos. Okay, so do watch all the videos of EKIDA and learn more and more of EDC 2 from EKIDA. Thank you very much.